All right. If you turn to Mark chapter 4, I'll be talking about faith. But before I talk about that, one of the first Bible verses I've ever remembered was 2 Corinthians 5:7, for we walk by faith, not by sight. And I remember the way I was taught this. I was a little kid, and they had two teachers. One was he was a serious guy, and the other guy, he was, like a funny, goofy guy. And so when he taught this, the goofy guy had some blindfolds on him. He goes, all right, I'm going to start walking by faith. He takes a few steps. He starts knocking over some stuff. And he's like, man, this is pretty tough. This is pretty tough. I don't like walking by faith, not by sight. The serious guy, the serious teacher, he was like, no, that's not the way. That's not the way you do it. You know, what it's really saying is, you know, have faith in the Word of God rather than doubting, you know, doubting by what you see. And that brings me to, you know, one, of course, we have this coronavirus going on. It brings a lot of people fear. But it got me to think about this part in Mark chapter 4. Verse 35, and it says, and the same day, when the even was come, he saith unto them, let us pass over to the other side. And when they had sent away the multitude, they took him, even as he was in the ship. And there was also with him other little ships. And there arose a great storm of wind, and the waves beat into the ship, so that it was now full. And he was in the hinder part of the ship, asleep on a pillow. And they awake him and saith unto him, Master, carest thou not that we perish? And he rose and rebuked the wind and saith unto the sea, peace, be still. And the wind ceased, and there was a great calm. And he saith unto them, why are ye so fearful? How is it that you have no faith? And they feared exceedingly, and said one to another, what manner of man is this, that even the wind and the sea obey him? You know, have you ever experienced fear? I mean, I don't know. Sometimes I feel like, you know, I look at, you know, some of you guys, and it seems like, you know, you guys are just fearless. You can take everything. But I've experienced, you know, some fear. You know, when you get fear, it's like you can't think right. You know, your mind is not set all the time. You know, it kind of reminds me of 1 Kings 19 when, you know, when Jezebel sent a messenger to tell Elijah that she was going to kill him. First thing he did is he ran. You know, he ran away. He was in fear. And he's like, God, just take me. Kill me. Yeah. You know, and you're talking about this man after he put on an awesome show. You know, he showed a great faith, and next day he's doing this. And, you know, when you experience fear, fear doesn't come like, you know, it's like, hey, schedule next Friday, you're going to be afraid at 5 o'clock. You know, it either gradually comes and it catches you off guard, or just, bam, it hits you and, you know, it kind of stops you. But fear stops you from moving forward, and it causes you to walk by sight. It doesn't cause you to walk by faith. Now, let's find out what Elijah and many other people in the Bible and what we should do when we face fear. Now, let's kind of read again Mark chapter 4. It says, in the same day when the even was come, he saith unto them, let us pass over to the other side. Now, who said, let's pass over to the other side? Jesus. So, is it safe to say that they were in the will of God to go into the other side? Amen. Right? So, let's keep reading. Verse 36. And when they had sent away the multitude, they took him, even as he was in the ship. And there was also with him other little ships. And there arose a great storm of wind, and the waves beat into the ship, so that it was now full. Now remember, Jesus told them to go to the other side, right? Meaning they were in the will of God. Now in the will of God, a storm came. You know, I've heard many times, you know, when you're in the will of God, you know, everything is going to be all right. You're never going to have any issues. Yeah. But that's not true, right? You know, but question, who was with them when they were in the storm? Jesus was with them. It was in the will of God. A storm came. There was a purpose to go to the other side. And there was a storm. And who was with them? Jesus. Jesus didn't abandon them, right? Now, it's funny how, you know, your flesh doesn't want you to do the will of God. You know, your flesh is always telling you, you know, man, I don't want to go soul winning. You know, just it's hot outside, or your flesh is like, man, I don't want to go to church today, or your flesh is like, man, it's late, I don't want to read the Bible today. Your flesh wants to hold you back from doing the will of God. You know, this world is set up that it doesn't want you to do the will of God. It kind of prevents you in every way to prevent you to do the will of God. And hey, we all know Satan doesn't want you to do the will of God, right? And you know, there must be a purpose for Jesus to tell the disciples to go onto the other side, right? Well, let's keep reading. In verse 38, it says, "And he was in the hinder part of the ship asleep on a pillow, and they awake him. And he saith unto him, Master, carest thou not that we perish? And he arose and rebuked the wind, and saith unto the sea, Peace, be still. And the wind ceased, and there was a great calm. And he said unto them, Why are you so fearful? How is it that you have no faith?" You know, your problems doesn't scare Jesus. You know, mind you, I would think, you know, in a boat, like we've been in a boat on our honeymoon. We went on a cruise, and the last night it was storming. They closed all the windows. The boat was rocking. That was terrifying, you know, and that was pretty bad. Mind you, it must have been really bad for these, you know, fishermen to be out in the boat and for them to panic and go to Jesus, and Jesus is sleeping on a pillow. And like, your problems literally doesn't scare God. And look what verse 41 says. Well, after he calmed the storm, it says, "And they feared exceedingly and said one to another, What manner of man is this, that wind and the sea obey him?" You know, sometimes we need a reminder about how great and mighty our God is when we're in a problem. You know, it says, "What manner of man is this, that even the wind and the sea obey him?" You know, when a storm comes, you know, are you walking by faith or are you walking by sight? You know, a lot of people will say, yeah, I trust God, but, or, you know, I have faith in God, but, you know, I know that God can, you know, help us out, but, and it's, you know, it's interesting, like when we go soul winning, you know, we knock on someone's door and we ask, hey, you know, what do you think it has to do to go to heaven? And it's, oh yeah, I believe on Jesus, but you have to do works. Do they believe on Jesus? No. So if you say, hey, in the midst of a storm, I trust Jesus, but do you trust Jesus? No, you don't. You're actually in fear. You kind of forget, you know, you're in a sense of after the storm, you're going to be like, wow, what manner of God is this? Instead of saying, this is the God who created the world. This is a God who created the universe. I love where I live now. You could actually see the sky, like the stars and everything. Every time I get home and it's late, I look up and I'm like, man, that is awesome. Look at these stars. You know, in Orlando, you have all these flashlights. You know, it's super bright. You can't really see so well. But down in the country, you can see everything. It's like, wow, this is awesome. Look how big our God is. Amen. You know, and it kind of brings it to the present time. That, is it the will of God for us to go to church?
Amen.
Yeah? What about, is it the will of God to go soul winning?
Amen.
You know, the storm is health scare. You know, the coronavirus, this crazy economy, and, you know, the media hyping everything in fear. And, hey, you know, the coronavirus is kind of it's scary, you know. At least, you know, I think so. You know, especially when one of my friends got it. You know, one of my friends got it back in early April, and he died within 48 hours. And it really shook me. I was like, oh, man, you know. Like, is it right? Should I really, you know, keep going to church? Like, this is crazy. Like, am I doing the right thing? You know, we kept going. And, you know, it was crazy because he died right after. Then, you know, all my other friends were like, you see, I told you, you should have stayed home. And then right after, my dad got it. And then all my family were like, oh, you know, you see, you need to stay home. You can't be going to church. You're going to get it. You know, this fear, like I said, it doesn't just, you know, it doesn't set an appointment. It hits you right where it's hard, and you have everyone wanting to stop you from doing the will of God. You know, but, you know, what they should have done on the boat is just press forward. Like, hey, look, God told us to go to the other side. He's here in the boat. Let's just ride out the storm, you know. But, hey, what happened when they got over to the other side? Have you read, Mark 5? There was a demon-possessed man, and he got delivered. And after he got delivered, he told everyone what Jesus did for him.
Amen.
You know? Now, how will it benefit your family if you continue to go to church in the will of God? You know, your kids will see this, you know, and they'll be like, you know what? During this crazy crisis, my parents still continue going to church. You know, my parents continue soul winning. In this crazy crisis when everyone's fearful, and hey, when we die and pass away and our kids are taking their kids to church, they're like, no, we didn't raise our family that way. There's a purpose. We need to continue going to church. You know, and what about soul winning? You know, it's I'm not going to lie. Sometimes you go, you know, it's like, man, it's crazy. Knocking the door. I'm like, wow, people get saved. You know, since what? We had 600 plus salvations since the coronavirus. What if we didn't, what if we stopped halfway? We didn't go. You know, we were in fear and we turned around and we're like, we're going to stay home. 600 people probably wouldn't have heard the gospel. And that's pretty scary. If we didn't, if we didn't continue riding the storm, because we don't know what, hey, we don't know what's going to happen. But who told us to continue to go to church? Jesus, right? Who told us to preach the gospel, right? And is he going to abandon us? And guess what? If we die, what's going to happen? We're in heaven. You know, I got a broken foot. It's not fully healed. You know, I'm kind of messed up where it kind of hurts me after a while. But, you know, if I do die, man, I'm not going to be in pain no more. I'm going to be really happy. But, you know, one verse that always gets me, you know, that I've been holding on to, I always refer back to is Psalms 34, verse 4. If you go to that, Psalms, you read full book of Psalms 34, it's really good, but when you read Psalms 34, 4, it says, I sought the Lord, and he heard me, and delivered me from all my fears. So if you're afraid of what's going on in this, you know, this world, you know, where it's constant fear, you go to work, it's fear, you go to Walmart, it's fear, you go to any place, you know, it's just fear mongering everywhere. Just, you know what, if you're afraid, seek after the Lord. Well, let's pray. Dear God, thank you, Father, for the sermon. And I pray that, you know, if we're in fear, I pray that, you know, we are motivated more to seek after things of you, Lord. Thank you, God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.